tu vois.
There you are. Come on, happy puppy. You gonna sing? Sing! Sing! Good boy.
You enjoying my spot puppy? Huh? You keeping my place warm? Just a big old rag doll, huh? Good boy. Big old teddy bear, yes you are. Mm-hmm. Maybe one day we'll show everybody that teddy bear command, huh? I think they'll get a kick out of that, huh? You just don't care if you're hot. You're just gonna lay there no matter what. You're just a happy puppy, huh? Happy Mr. Puppies. Hey, y'all. I usually don't plan to do a lot as far as product reviews, but if I'm gonna buy something and not be happy with it as soon as I get it, I might as well share it at the moment because I do have all the stuff here. And it all goes to, on my last video, I was saying I was going to get some sort of a tripod, handheld, something to keep my fingers from getting in the view of the video. So I went to our local Walmart, didn't have much to choose from, and I am a budget guy, and sometimes, honestly, that saying, you get what you pay for, it's very true. Now, I'm going to honestly tell you, this product line that Walmart has started to carry is, just stay away from it, personally. Don't give it a try. Their earbuds don't work good either. You can go get a pair at the Dollar Tree that's gonna work just as good as the earbuds that they're gonna sell you for $5 or $6, or you know what I mean. I do have a pair of Skull Candy that you can get for $10 offline, and the hearing quality is pretty darn great for a basic set of earbuds. But nonetheless, I'm just gonna explain on this right here. I just wanted something simple, and they had a $5 or $10 set right here. I decided to go with the $10 because it's giving the appearance that it's a stronger style because it's wider than the one half its price, okay? And ooh, it's got a little finger button push for cameras and whatnot. Hey, for me having to walk around, usually I carry a walking stick. I'm limited with my hands. So that was an interesting feature to come along with this, okay? But this wide heavy-duty looking system is pretty darn weak. And I'll show you that. Okay, I got it set up now. I used a couple packs of batteries to mimic the same weight of a cell phone and kind of held both in my hands. Now, I got her extended out right here, okay? And it's very, very weak. It wiggles right here in the middle. This tubing that they use is honestly basically like a radio antenna, and some of you younger people are not familiar with radio antennas, and that's okay, but they are very hollow and weak. And the inside of this thing, I'm just gonna bring it down a little bit, it's just a little ribbed bend they have in the middle right there. But this thing is very weak. If you're gonna extend it out and use the weight of a cell phone on the end of this, if you were to accidentally bang it into something one time, it will create a crease in this and will easily break off, okay? I could see me banging this by accident the very first time I try to use it. And once you do that, the system is honestly toast, okay? The telescope rods here are really a pathetic piece of metal and something they shouldn't try to attempt to sell you this way, okay? Like I said, you get what you pay for, and it's going back. I'm gonna get something better. Look at that. Interesting.
All right, straight ahead you have.
All right, not gonna show much, but I just got in the room. This is the room they're gonna be setting me up for a sleep study. They got a couple of things up there for a mask. This is the bathroom. Already filled out all my paperwork. Had to go to the bathroom. And I'm getting ready to get hooked up.
Ready for the night, okay.
Jeez. All that I'm hooked up to. That is just ridiculous. And I'm not showing you, but it's honestly, it's from head to toe. Every single wire is connected somewhere. Okay, we're back again. Sorry, there's not much more to update at this moment, but I promise real soon we're going to finish showing you how I got the gutter aquaponics set up for this indoor pond. But today I just wanted to give a quick I guess you would say an in-depth explanation on how my inverted aquarium is set up, free suspended. Once again, like I said, I used electrical wire, like speaker wire or any sort of wire that's got a coating on it, for when you decide to go around your aquarium, you make sure that it grips the top lip so it can handle the extra pull that the inverted aquarium is giving for the drop. And I prefer to use lacing wire, and I do have it spread out just enough for the balancing of my inverted aquarium on top, okay? This way, once you get it set up, you can kind of push it down and give it more of a level bend in the wiring versus where a string could kind of keep it in some sort of a uneven setting, because this is a pentagon on top of an octagon, and for where I had to set my lines, it's definitely not symmetrical, okay? It had to work the way it works to make it work exactly, and ended up turning into more of a fry breeder tank on top because big boys or Sarah and Chub Chub can't even get up in there, you know. They don't even attempt or try. They stay down below and the fry stay up here quite often. You know, and I'm going to also let you know there is no longer Tigger. Tigger was the female guppy that was a companion to Tony the Tiger, which is my male guppy in here. And she ended up passing away. So now his main companion is Ernie, where Bert was her main companion. So they've kind of switched up. I do happen to have the offspring from both genetic groups in this tank to continue the breeding. I'm going to get a few more males, but I happen to have quite a few females. And this way it does not stay one genetic line per se. But we're going to worry about that once we get the inverted pondarium, I guess that's what I would call it, set up. But like I was saying, it's kind of neat how the plants decided to engulf the top inverted tank and turn it into more of a fry sanctuary. I really thought that was pretty interesting. And using an acrylic tank or any type of a, you know, clear jar, bowl, as long as you use some sort of a proper line like I'm showing here, it doesn't have to be exactly what I'm using. This is just what I happen to have and what I came up with, and I haven't done nothing to this tank since I've done this, okay? Since I moved them over here, this is the way they've just set up. A lot of things are going on right now medically and whatnot. Also our weather, things have been slow. But I plan to continue updating you guys with everything going on. My next upload will be, like I said again, the gutter system and how all that works. And I will explain that in detail in case anybody wishes to follow along. Once again, thanks for watching Why Not in Wyoming, because, you know, I do this because why not? Simple as that. Y'all take care. Have a blessed day. We'll see you on the next flip-flop.